Yo, what's up? Today I'm going to show you how to be a weirdo and mod on zombies in Black Ops 2. Also, I have to voice over this because my mic was being gay. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but like it was being weird and popping and stuff. So yeah, I'm voicing this over. But connect to Xbox Live and go down to leaderboards. And then once you're at leaderboards, you want to scroll over to grenade kills and then press Y to change the filter from all or from friends to all. Then hit apply and press X to go to the top of the list. Then use the D-pad to scroll down by like 20 and then scroll down to 653 where you'll see a guy by the name of UY. Then just click on his profile and go down to player channel. And then once you're in player channel, go down to edited films. Now you're going to see a bunch, but you want to choose the one that says Iconic In Effect Part 1. So just go ahead and press on it. I don't know what I'm really doing right here. But yeah, just go ahead and press on it and then start the film up. Now once you've loaded into theater, it might take a second to load. Some days this works, some days it doesn't. Some days it just won't load at all. But today it's working as of February 21st, I think. But just go ahead and start it up. And what you're going to want to do is you're going to say that the duration is only a minute and 41 seconds. But it's actually like 2.5 minutes. And it's just going to keep playing even though it hits the end. But that's fine. That's normal. But just keep going. Keep watching it until it freezes. And you want to make sure that you don't press like A or like take a screenshot or anything. Just like set your controller down and let it play out because you don't want to mess it up. And yeah, also this isn't bannable. Like you might get kicked but or like disconnected from online for like a minute or two, but like you're not gonna get like banned. And if you do get banned, it's not gonna be like your like Xbox or your PlayStation account. Also this only works on I think Xbox One and PS4 and then maybe the new gen consoles too, but it doesn't work on 360 or the PS3. As you can see, we're at the end, and the clip has like completely frozen. And once it's completely frozen like this, wait like a second or two, something like that, and then just go ahead and leave the film. So now once you've loaded it, just back out, go back to leaderboards, go back to grenade kills, and then filter it all again. Go back to the top of the list, and then go back down to 653 to the UI guy. And then this time, instead of choosing part 1 of Iconic In Effect, you want to go to edited films and choose part 2. And this one is way quicker, it's only like 15 seconds long. But just load in, and then yeah, just start it up just like before. And then don't screenshot or anything, and just wait for it to freeze. Like I said, it only takes like 15 seconds. But if your game crashes, or if you like close out or whatever, then you're gonna have to rewatch all the films and stuff again if you want the mod menu back. And you gotta keep following the steps in this video if you want to use it in public lobbies. So once it freezes again, just wait a second or two just like before, and then go ahead and end the film again. But this time we're done, we actually have the mod now. So what you want to do if you want to use it in public lobbies now is back out and go into solo play, and then I don't think it matters, I think you can just load up any map or whatever. Gonna see in the left, it's gonna have your gamer tag, and then it's gonna say Project Iconic Sentinel Edition, whatever. And now just aim. Oh, my controller. Okay, aim, and then like knife to pull up the mod menu. And as you can see, there's a whole bunch of mods. And basically, the way it works is you press X to like select, and then you use the D-pad to scroll like up and down, and then you press right stick to back out. So be careful with some of these things though, because they will crash your game. But like you can change your FOV and everything, but make sure you, as you just saw me do, you turn on Force Host and then just back out and join a public match if you want to use it in a public match, because you have to be the host. But it's going to take a while to find a match because like you're hosting the server instead of joining somebody else's. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Just like be too careful, don't crash your game, don't like fry your Xbox or whatever. But yeah, that's for me, and peace out.